is the my favorite one. In this one, you can move around and spin around and look at whatever you want to look at, okay? Just be aware of the cord.
How do I grab it?
Right trigger.
Come here. Oh, this one.
Oh, switch hands if you're right handed. Are you right handed?
Yeah, you're right handed.
Just switch the hands.
It's okay.
Okay.
So I'm looking at a sign. This looks like I'm backstage.
La Paix. You are backstage.
Dance Poem by Paul Duca.
Oh my god, I'm standing on a platform that's moving, and it looks like I'm on a platform.
Yeah, isn't that really cool?
Whoa.
So I'm recording this via the computer so we can make this into a Let's Play for later.
And so it happened that at the end of days, the Prince Iskander on the threshold of death scaled the farthest reaches in search of the flower of immortality. He traversed the 12 galaxies without finding it, finally reaching a forgotten land at the outer limits of the universe.
By the way, hello to everybody that's watching right now.
Yeah, we're periscoping this.
Woo! I'm probably all turned around. I don't... Oh, there's the carpet.
Don't worry, it's okay.
His quest was coming to an end. On the steps leading up to the Temple of Hormazd, the icon of a Peri was standing in her pristine dress. The flower of immortality shining on her bosom.
Ooh. Oh, and there's the moon up there. Holy fuck. Oh my god.
I know, it looks real, doesn't it?
I mean, it's like you can still tell that it's like a video game, but it feels like I'm actually in the video game.
Like video games are real.
Yeah, video games are real. Whoa, holy shit. Whoa.
The lotus suddenly broke into four shining petals of light. Without the flower of immortality, the Peri was no longer able to fulfill her destiny and descend into the Light of Hormazd. Iskander now needed to bring the four scattered petals back together again.
Whoa. It looks kind of like a crystal vagina.
You don't have to look back at me. You're not gonna see me. I know, it looks like it's gonna hit me.
I know. Like, I feel so silly, but at the same time.
Grab it.
Oh, you tricky little thing. Come back.
It'll come back. But do you want to take it? Do you want to take it, Soul?
I don't know.
You have to be fast. Just, like, snatch it.
I don't know what it does, though. I don't want to
hurt
it.
Just snatch it. You can give it back if you want.
Whoa.
But eventually you do have to take it to advance the story. I just wanted to let you know that you had options. Now put that into your scepter. Yeah, it looks like there's glowy things all
the
around.
The prince
you,
ignored the spirit and placed the petal safely on his scepter. He then left to pursue his quest for the three remaining petals.
Holy fuck.
Stacy's wearing her Game Whisk thing. Oh, I forgot. Do it
see
again.
The
do it again.
Darkness that lay beneath the temple. A light caught Iskander's attention. It was a petal from the precious lattice.
I don't know if you saw, but I wrote my name.
I know, I showed them. Oh, you're saying my name!
Yeah! You have to go fast, though, because it goes away.
You know what? When I turn on,
oh, no. I feel like there's gotta be a person around here somewhere, and I just...
You're too busy looking and too distracted? Don't worry. No, look! Look up! Look up! Look at the reds! At face level.
Whoa.
Concentrate. The matter, concentrate on if you know it's really distracting, but
to steal it from the new avatar of the spirit. With a new petal from the flower of life in his possession,
Skander set out on the journey. Just play this game.
You're what?
I'm gonna give you a painting program in a bit. Just play this game.
Wow. Alright, this is incredible.
His steps soon led him to a dark hallway where a rustling could be heard.
Only two petals left.
Another petal was close to
Skander. It would be a good idea to observe the creatures that are following around you, just so you can look at them,
Yeah. Oh, whoa. It looks like a person, kind of.
Take your flashlight off of it. You can see it better that way. But that's the creature you want to get. Walk up to it.
Oh, it's like a little monkey thing.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Oh my god.
Do I look like a total goofball right now?
You look like a badass trying to catch an invisible monkey. Oh, you got it. So for the next
Skander
one,
was overtaken
so you don't get
by
ruined
hope,
your experience,
as the entire flower of immortality would soon be in his possession.
He's just pushing me.
He's pushing you?
Yeah.
He's probably like, what is she doing right now? Why isn't she petting me?
He's just confused. Both the dogs are really confused. They're like, what the fuck is going on? Sexy light lady. Now walk up to her. Walk up to her.
He swiftly cut its path by way of a shortcut and then stood still for before his eyes.
Remember that you can follow her around and anything you do. So just keep watching her.
Whoa.
I just want you to have the best experience.
Of Paris,
take your flashlight out for her.
Stepped away from her, torn
okay.
Between his thirst for immortality and his eyes' civilization.
Okay.
While the Persians dance and supplications, Iskander sees the flower's petal, and the immortal prince returns to his kingdom, bearer of the flower of life, and of a nagging regret, that of having deprived
the
fairy of
yes! Why? Because you killed her! I've never killed her! I've played this so many times, and I never killed her!
I didn't even, is there a story to this game? I haven't followed,
You were just too amazed? Too overwhelmed?
Too amazed. I was like, oh, the thingy in front of me? Sure.
It says, choose your life or hers.
Oh, my God.
You killed her! You killed her!
In front of me, I chose it.
And then as you were putting it towards your scepter, I was like, no! Don't do it! Why?
Oh, that's so funny.
Why did you murder her? If you let her live, she spins around and jumps in the air and flies away.
What's the story of this game?
You're a prince and you want immortality, so you try to steal the petals of life. But then at the end, she dances for you, and she's supposed to convince you to give the petals back!
I'm such an asshole!
She's just supposed to give the petals back!
Oh
like,
it's
just choose your life or hers, and if you give it back to her, she, does this amazing dance and flies into the air and, spins off into the world, and you're surrounded by beautiful light! And you murder her! You killed her!
Iskander, on the threshold of death, scaled the farthest reaches in search of the flower of immortality. He traversed the 12 galaxies without finding it, finally reaching a forgotten land at the outer limits of the universe.
Okay, so basically, you're a prince who wants
his quest was coming to an end. On the steps leading up to the Temple of Hormazd, the icon of a Peri was standing in her crystal dress, the flower of immortality shining on her bosom. The lotus suddenly broke into 4 shining petals of life. Without the flower of immortality, the Peri was no longer able to fulfill her destiny and descend into the Lord of Armor.
This is the thing you thought looked like a vagina.
Needed to bring the Force country at its back together again.
Oh yeah, I see it. Right?
Pursue his quest for the three remaining petals.
Oh, I feel like I'm moving down. It's really weird. Dance 2.
In the darkness that lay
finding
beneath
other
the
petals hidden in the temple,
a light caught Iskander's attention. It was a petal from the precious lotus. With a new petal from the Flower of Life in his possession, Iskander set out on his journey again. His steps soon led him to a dark hallway where a rustling could be heard. Another petal was close to Iskander. The prince glanced at it.
So this little monkey has been live action captured by a ballerina pretending to be a monkey.
Oh.
Yeah, it's like, so I can put that on screen. I won't be lazy about it. But this is live action captured by a ballerina.
Pretending to be a monkey, huh?
Iskander was overtaken by hope as the entire flower of immortality would soon be in his possession. A shortcut, and then is to distill for before his eyes are filled. The dance of Paris, while the prince stepped away from her, torn between his thirst for mortality and his eyes of danger. Deeply moved and enthralled by her dance, Iskander gave the petals back to the peri without regret. Iskander saw her disappear, and as he understood that this meant his end was near, he felt the shadows around.
Down like a thing.
Yeah.
Is that weird?
Yeah. No,
it's so strange.
When I was playing the filing cabinet one,
it feels like you're moving around.
It felt like you were moving all over the place.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm bowing. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, that's okay.